Pull up a chair. It's time. It's tool testing time. So what we're going to use here is we've got a, what we got there? A 3x8 freshly milled Doug fir timber. Relatively green. So we're going to drill 1-inch holes. So right there you can see that we've got the closest to you is the adjustable Irwin. I've got that set at 1-inch. Actually, let's go over that and I'll show you how to set that up. So the Irwin adjustable, again, I've never used this one before, but it looks like you can go from 3/4 of an inch, clear up, looks like maybe even up to 2-inch. Let's just start with the basic bit here. So we'll chuck this up. I'll use the ratcheting brace. These braces, you change the section or change the way that it ratchets right here in this dial. So in and out, just like that. We'll start with a 1-inch standard bit. On your mark, get set, go. There, you can feel it through. So if we flip it over here, we'll see that we are indeed through. We'll just stop them right there. So we can see that the hole is very clean, super precise, no tear out there at all. A really nice, clean 1-inch hole. So now we'll chuck up the Irwin 21, the adjustable, on the same brace. So having never used one of these, I don't know exactly what to expect, but I do kind of expect it to not work as well. You know, whenever you get these multi-purpose type of tools, like a Leatherman and such, yeah, they will work as pliers. They're not the best pliers. So we'll see. So I've got it adjusted at 1-inch, and on your mark, get set. Go. Got here. It was maybe took a little bit more effort, not a great deal, but not quite as smooth, but I wouldn't say it was bad at all. Actually, it was quite good there. So if we flip it over here, we can see that we did indeed come through. There's our first hole. Pretty clean. I was expecting to have a little bit of tear out there, kind of a ragged edge, but I really can't see much difference. Is what it is there. You're looking at it just as I am. I can't see any difference. Apart from just being a little bit, just not quite as smooth, I can't see any difference in the hole. It's good alternative. I mean, kind of nice if you have to go out and drill multiple holes to have one tool in your box versus several, but I'm surprised. I did not expect it to work that well. Let's test the belly drill, or the shoulder drill here. Put it on my shoulder. Actually, it feels too short for my shoulder. I'm gonna put it on the belly. Try that. All right. On your mark. Get set. Go. Oh, it's that's not going to work. Speed's too high. Now again, I'm learning with you guys here. I have not used this before. So obviously the speed was too high. I couldn't get the torque on it. So we'll go to the lower gear. That's a pretty good size hole for a hand drill, a 1-inch like that. So let's see if that doesn't work a little better. Now we didn't really drill much of a hole there, so we'll back it out. All right, on your mark, get set, and go.
It's not very comfortable. It's definitely operator error here, I'm sure.
Yeah, this is terrible.
Oh, I'm not enjoying this. It's painful. Very difficult. A lot of work. Very uncomfortable.
I don't like the belly drill. I don't know about that. Obviously, you can't just expect to know how to do something right off the bat. That's not great. I'm not even gonna try this one. I'm just gonna say that I'm probably not gonna use the belly drill. I know you saw it sitting there, and there no test would be complete without trying the test of the beam drill. Now, I don't have a 1-inch drill bit for the beam drill, but I do have 1.5 inches, so it's even a bigger bit. But let's try it. Let's see how the beam drill does compared to the other ones. All right, we're going 1.5 inches instead of 1 inch. On your mark, get set, go. I'm through or not. Nope. There we go. That was much better. That was actually quite enjoyable. And a whole lot less effort. Let's take a look at the hole.